Now, former National Party leader Simon Bridges has penned a book about his life. National Identity is full of embarrassing anecdotes, amusing family photos and his theories about everything from race to masculinity.
So what better place to talk about the book and Bridges' life than a horror-themed escape room? And just a note, the story was filmed before lockdown.
Simon Bridges is on his book tour, which means he'll agree to anything for publicity. So he didn't flinch when I suggested a visit to Escape Masters as a venue for our chat.
All I need from you guys is I decide on a team name.
Team Spew. Okay.
Now, the reason I'm calling it Team Spew is because one of the stories in Simon's book, you spewed all over one of the senior partners.
Yeah.
One of the first times that you went to a social occasion as a summer clerk.
No, it wasn't good.
So Team Spew.
You look okay.
I look like I've had some methamphetamine.
You actually do.
3, 2, 1. Cool. Okay.
Yeah. Is this a bit scary for you? I imagine that this escape room thing might be a bit freaky because I know about your religious background because I've read all about it in the book. Is this the occult? Are we involved in the occult?
I feel like it's deeply sacrilegious, but it's okay because I know what side I'm on and I'm going to win. It's all right.
I get the feeling when I'm reading it that you struggle a little bit with your identity.
You know, part of it's self-help for me, right? Working out post being the leader of the National Party, what that kind of meant for me, actually my relationship with my parents, which I think is important for everyone. But things like the chapter on race, feeling not Maori enough to Maori and working all of that out. I'm not a victim. I'm not telling you that I've got grievances or anything, but we're no longer running around in caves.
But as we were running around an escape room and failing, it occurred to me that Neanderthals would have fared better than us chimps. We were struggling.
You try 6'6"?
Is this the hardest situation that you've ever tried to get out of?
No.
Really?
No, I'm sure there's been harder. I mean, there's been plenty of stuff.
Really?
But I feel like this is a good representation.
What, just sort of trapped in some horrific room?
Who would you rather be in this escape room with out of Judith Collins, Christopher Luxon? Who would you like to be out of? Obviously, you're in here, you got either Luxon or you got Collins. Who's your partner to get out of here?
I actually think Judith would be a good problem solver in this room.
Luxon, hopeless at solving problems?
I think he might be okay.
But we didn't need the help of Luxon or Collins, because eventually Bridges and Wells found their way out of the haunted motel. But one question remained.
We did it.
Well done. Well done.
I mean, I wouldn't tell you the stuff about being unco, spewing, not being able to back a trailer, not being able to drive a boat, getting beaten up, being religious. They're not things I think you'd say if you were on the big leadership comeback trail.
Will you rule out ever being the leader of the National Party?
Right here, right now, in the Exorcist escape room.
Can you rule it out?
I'm ruling it out.
You're ruling it out?
I'm ruling it out.